this is Mick Burgess. I'm now joined backstage at the Riverside in Newcastle with Michael Wilton from Queensrÿche. Michael, it's a pleasure to see you. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. I'm happy to be here, and thanks for having me.
A little bit cold tonight?
A little bit cold. It's, you know, the venue's been a little chilly today, and you know, we're here. We love it. And actually, the cold air is refreshing.
It is. At least it's not raining.
It's not raining.
So tonight's the last night of your UK tour here in Newcastle. How's the tour gone for you?
It's gone great. Package that's been going through Europe is almost a month long, and you know, started down in Greece. We started in Thessaloniki and Athens, and we've made our way through Europe, and now here we're in the UK. Yeah. And it's been a great time. The lineup we have with Firewind and Dark Sky Choir, sorry, that one's a hard one to say, and it's a great package, and the fans are loving it. They're eating it up.
Excellent. I mean, you must have mixed feelings at the end of a tour. You know, you've been playing all these places. You know, you'll be going home soon. So it's a happy time, but also a sad time when you finish the run of shows.
Yeah, I mean, once we head back December 9th, and then we have 2 days, and then we do some fly gigs in the United States. We're done on the 21st of December. Then we have some time off, and then we start up the U.S. tour January 15th.
So not a lot of time off, really, is it?
Not really, not till later off in the year.
Your first appearance in Newcastle, this is your first appearance since 2011 when you... open for Judas Priest. Does it feel good to be back in Newcastle? It's been a while since we've seen you.
Yeah, and you know, we're obviously touring on this album, The Verdict, and it's really been well received. And thus, you know, as far as the touring aspect, we're able to go to places where the album has charted and you know, gain some appreciation. So. And for us, you know, it's important to build these relationships again and to come to these cities, you know, maybe every other year or even yearly, you know. But for us on this run, it's great. Some of the cities that we've gone to, we haven't been to in 15 years.
Because obviously the first time you did play in Newcastle, you were with Dio, played in Newcastle City Hall around the corner. I think it was Rage for Order had just come out. I mean, what were your memories of that? Was that your first tour of the UK then?
I believe it was. Yeah. And that was, you know, that was back in 1985.
Yeah.
So I was pretty young.
Yeah.
And, it was a great tour. We sure learned a lot from Dio in those early days. And he was very gracious and you know, he was nice to us and showed us, you know, the positive side of the industry. Yeah. So, anyway, that was some great concerts that we had over here.
Of course, he sort of made that appearance on Mindcrime 2 as well many years later.
Yes, you know, we had the opportunity. He was in town and he did some guest spots, and then he came and did that live for us.
Oh, right.
Once, and that was you know, a great moment for us.
Yeah. Your current tour, what sort of set list have you got lined up? There's obviously some songs from the new album. Are you sort of digging deep into the back catalogue and playing a few you haven't done for a while?
Well, you know, with the set list, it's always ever ending and ever, you know, we're at each other's throats trying to decide what we want to play, what the fans want to hear, what new songs we can put into the set, how the set flows, how long do we get, how long are the, you know, putting it all together, there's a lot goes into it. So, but this set list, we're you know, trying to promote some of the new Queensrÿche into the legacy songs that, you know, everybody wants to hear as well. And then you've got the hardcore Queensrÿche fans that, you know, want to hear the new stuff. So it's kind of a good balance, but it's a good energetic show. And I think, you know, you can't please everybody.
No,
you know,
no.
With 15 albums worth of material. So, but we do our best.
Yeah. Is it a democratic process when you choose the songs, or does somebody have a casting vote?
It's democratic. You know, we kind of just feel it out, you know, and just see which songs go into each other. You know, you have obviously the keys of the songs and how they relate, but you know, it is a process.
It is indeed. And obviously, the last time we saw you with Judas Priest, Jeff's left and Todd's come into the band. Mm-hmm. Jeff was always considered one of the great metal vocalists of his generation, so it's quite a difficult task getting a voice in that can sing that material. Obviously, Todd has nailed it perfectly. I mean, how difficult did you, I mean, did you know Todd beforehand? Did you know that's the man we want, or did you have to look around?
Strange story, actually. Well, when I first met Todd, I met him as a drummer.
Yes.
So, you know, and then when things happened, you know, he said, hey, by the way, I sing as well. So
it was kind of a drummer first.
Yes.
All right.
So it was, yeah, double plus good.
So I thought he was a Phil Collins in reverse, but yeah, Phil Collins the right way around. Yeah.
But yeah, you know, and all bands go through changes, and you have to constantly be reinventing yourself, you know, it was definitely needed. Things had gotten stagnant, and you know, made a big decision, and you know, and with Todd La Torre, it's been 6 years, almost going on 7 years, and we really built the band up again, and you know, and we're able to tour the world.
Yeah, and do you feel like yourself? The music to me on the outside, it feels rejuvenated as a listener. Do you feel that yourself?
Well, yeah, because I mean, you know, when we first started touring, the fans really wanted to hear the old stuff because they were never hearing it. And so, you know, we reached back into the old albums and really supported those in the first early tours of like 2013. And you know, now it's to a point where it's a good mix of everything.
Yeah.
And I think, you know, for places that we haven't been to in, you know, 10 or 15 years, it's really amazing to see their faces when they hear some of the old stuff and the new stuff. So
which ones do you enjoy sort of revisiting again that you haven't played for a while?
Well, I mean, obviously the main song that we'd have never played, you know, in the past was Queen of the Reich. And you know, that's the beginning, you know, when we were you know, I think I was 20 years old or something, so when that was recorded. And you know, and we go back and we try and represent as many of the albums as we can, mainly the legacy, the important ones.
So you've now recorded three albums with Todd. So how do you feel that you've progressed as a band since Todd's joined?
I think, you know, we're getting more comfortable as musicians. And that's important because Queensrÿche is all about the musicianship. And I think, you know, we've grown together as friends, and we've grown together as, you know, songwriters. So I think it's just a kind of a matured process that's happening. And, you know, everybody is very, very, you know, ambitious with plenty of creativity to put into the pot to get things stirred up.
And your latest album, The Verdict, came out earlier this year. I mean, the reaction's been really, really positive. You must be thrilled with that.
Oh yeah, I mean, it was so well received all over the world, and you know, we charted like in Germany the highest we've ever charted ever. So you know,
it's incredible sort of success for a band that's been around for such a long time.
Exactly, and so you know, it's generated great reviews. The fans love it, and. You know, we'll probably tour on it hopeful we are going to tour on it, you know, all of 2020.
Yeah.
We still have that. And then, you know, then we got to plant the seed to start, you know, writing the next record.
Because, never ends, does it?
Yes, we are a band that has a record company. Yeah. Actually, we do put out new records.
So how different is the songwriting process with Todd in the band? And do you think it's more open to people putting ideas forward? Because, you know, I've read the stories about Jeff being quite in control of the process. Do you think it's a bit more open now?
Oh yeah, it's, you know, it's like the old days when, like, DeGarmo and I used to just, you know, trade off riffs and build songs off of each other's parts, and a lot of that is the way we do things now. It's you know, obviously we're in the digital multimedia age, and, you know, now we email ideas back and forth, and you know, it's the same process. You throw the paint on the canvas and you see if it sticks. There's lots of bands that just live off their hits and can play casinos in the U.S. and make a good living at it, but or just play their hits, period, you know? But we're a band that's always pushing forward, trying to be innovative and trying to reinvent itself with each album. And, you know, we got a record company that believes in us, so we'll keep putting out new music as long as our fans want us to.
And you're one half of the guitar duo with Parker Lundgren. Mm-hmm. How do you decide who gets which solo? Do you bring the solo and say, right, this is mine, or does Parker sometimes play one and say, oh, I want to do that one?
It's very natural and very organic. Like if someone has written the main body of a song and they have an idea of what the solo is going to be, have at it, you know. And if it works, it works. If it doesn't, then we'll look at it and reinvestigate. But it's just, you know, it's just being, I guess, practical of the different styles that we are, and whatever works. There's no set rule, you know. It's just whatever works is what's best for the song. Yeah.
So when Chris DeGarmo first left, and Kelly came to the band, and now and then obviously Parker, did you take that as an opportunity to sort of divvy up the solos a bit differently? So you said, well, I like that one of Chris's, I'll do that one this time. Did you sort of do that?
We really tried. I mean, it was first, you know, I was going to be just doing my solos, and he was going to do Chris's, and that didn't turn out so well. So, you know, so it was apparent that, you know, eventually if this was going to continue, we needed somebody that was not just going to, you know, pour their own personality and style, but actually, you know, respect DeGarmo's style.
Yeah. Just the last couple of questions just to round off. Scott's still an official member of Queensrÿche, right? He's on sort of hiatus at the moment. And is Casey Grillo doing the tour?
Casey's doing the tour. He's been touring with us now for, I think, close to almost 3 years. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Scott is, you know, doing his family thing and taking a break, and we respect his privacy and let him do what he wants to do. But right now, Casey's doing a great job. The fans love him.
He's a good drummer in Camelot, absolutely.
Yes.
To me, he's a perfect person to stand in. Mm-hmm. But Todd actually played the drums on the album.
Right, you know, and even the last two albums, Todd had been doing the demos. He had been doing the drums. And so with the verdict, he had done all the demo drums. So it was natural that, you know, he could actually record the album easier than if we brought in Casey or an outside studio drummer. So that was, you know, that was a decision that, you know, we just had to basically, you know, make sure that Todd could still play.
It's a very natural,
you know, you know, we set up a drum kit, and he did the first song, and it was thumbs up. The producer, Zeus, said, this is a no-brainer.
Mm-hmm. Did you get paid twice? So your tour ends tonight in Newcastle. You've got a couple more shows before Christmas. Mm-hmm. What have you got planned for Christmas this year?
Well, personally, you know, I'm going to go visit with my family. So I'll have a brief moment of time there. And then it's back into rehearsals for the U.S. tour in January. So
and work on the new album as well.
We'll have pockets of time for, you know, it's like think tanks sessions to get that thing going. Yeah.
The busy times ahead, which
yes,
is great.
Which is good.
Indeed. Well, Michael, it's been an absolute pleasure. Best of luck with your last show of the tour tonight in England. And have a great year. And hopefully see you next again next year.
Yes, of course. And thank you for supporting Queensrÿche.